Dear friends, in this video, I will demonstrate you the pathophysiology of Alzheimer's disease. Welcome to our YouTube channel, SRIP EduForm. I am Dr. Sanjay Gupta, Associate Professor in Sri Rao Sarkar Institute of Pharmacy. So let's start the topic. First of all, let me tell you what is Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease is CNS disorder or brain disorder in which there is progressively degeneration of neurons occurs. Unfortunately, the exact cause of this disorder is still unknown. It is the common form of dementia, that is loss of memory. This Alzheimer's disease generally starts in the late middle age or in the old age. Alzheimer's disease results in gradual and progressive loss of memory, impairment in the thinking capability, leads to disorientation and confusion, and affects the personality and behavior of the person. This disease includes mainly three things, that is degeneration of neurons, especially in the cerebral cortex of the brain, formation of neurofibrillary tangles, and formation of plaques containing beta amyloid cells. Now the origin of Alzheimer's disease. This disease was first identified and described by a German physician, Dr. Alois Alzheimer, in year 1906. He discovered this disease first, so the Alzheimer's disease was named after him. Dr. Alzheimer had a patient named Auguste D. who was suffered from a mental illness like disease. When she died, an autopsy was performed that confirmed the dense deposits, that is neuritic plaques, surrounded to the nerve cells of the brain. Inside of the brain cells, there was an accumulation of strands of fibers, or we can say neurofibrillary tangles. It is a CNS or brain disorder which gradually and progressively destroys the ability to reason, to remember, to imagine, to think, or to learn. In this picture, we can clearly see the difference between the normal brain and the Alzheimer's diseased patient's brain. In Alzheimer's disease, the cerebral cortex is extremely shrinked. The hippocampus part of the brain is also highly shrinked, and the ventricles are severely enlarged as compared to the normal brain. As per WHO information on Alzheimer's disease, about 3% of the men and women ages 65 to 74 have Alzheimer's disease, and nearly half of those age 85 and older may have the disease. Every year, around 360,000 new cases of Alzheimer's disease are diagnosed around the world. Now, come to the cause of Alzheimer's disease. The exact cause of Alzheimer's disease is still not known. However, several factors are thought to be responsible for the generation and progression of the disease. These factors are classified as neurochemical factors, environmental factors, genetic and immunological factors, and other risk factors. So, come to the first, neurochemical factors. It involves the changes in the level of various neurotransmitters or neurochemicals that act as a messenger of the nerve impulses, like acetylcholine, norepinephrine, somatostatin, and substance P. Various environmental factors are there responsible for the degeneration of neurons and leads to the Alzheimer's disease. It includes certain infections, cigarette smoking, metals, industrial or other toxins, and use of cholesterol-lowering drugs, for example, statins. Next is the genetic and immunological factors. One example is that oxidized LDL receptor 1 and angiotensin converting enzyme, that is ACE, are tied to the way the brain cells bind to the apolipoprotein 4, that is APOE4, and reduce buildup of harmful proteins, that is known as plaque, that is formed in the brain. In this picture, formation of plaques has been shown, that is deposited in the brain neurons, and that will further lead to the progression of the Alzheimer's disease. Other risk factors that may induce the degeneration of neurons are Down syndrome, which is also known as trisomy 21. It is a genetic disorder caused by the presence of all or part of a third copy of chromosome 21. It is usually associated with physical growth delays, mild to moderate intellectual disability, and characteristic facial features. Next is family history, chronic high blood pressure, any head injuries, gender, habitual smoking and drinking. Now let me describe the main objective of this presentation, that is pathophysiology of Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease attacks the nerves and brain cells and affects the release and functioning of the neurotransmitters. Such destructions of these parts causes clumps of proteins to form around the brain cells. These clumps of proteins are known as plaques and bundles. These plaques and bundles starts to destroy more connections between the brain cells, that further leads in worsening the condition of the neurons. Now come to the flowchart to understand the pathophysiology of Alzheimer's disease step by step. Several etiological factors that are already discussed are involved to induce changes in the proteins of the nerve cells of cerebral cortex. These harmful proteins get accumulated in nerve cells as neurofibrillary tangles and in development of plaques. These plaques further leads to granulovascular degeneration, and it increases the loss of cholinergic nerve cells. Due to loss of cholinergic nerve cells, it further causes the loss of memory, loss of function, and loss of cognition. In this picture, we can see the development of neurofibrillary tangles in the neuron cells and formation of amyloid plaques around the brain cells in the Alzheimer's diseased neuron cells compared to the normal neuron. In this picture, an enzyme has been shown to act on the amyloid precursor protein, that is APP, and cut it into fragments. These fragments leads to the formation of senile plaques in the Alzheimer's disease. Here in this picture, it is shown that the microtubules have tau molecules in their structure that helps them to maintain their stability. In Alzheimer's disease, alteration in the tau proteins leads to the disintegration of the microtubules in the brain cells. There are number of signs in the Alzheimer's disease as loss of memory, difficulty in performing familiar tasks, problem with the communication, disorientation to time and place, poor and misjudgment, problems with abstract thinking, misplacing things, changes in moods and behaviors, changes in personality, and loss of initiative ability. The symptoms of Alzheimer's disease includes confusion, short-term memory loss, problem with attention and spatial orientation, alteration in personality, difficulty in communication, and unexplained mood swing. The Alzheimer's disease can be diagnosed by several methods. It may include psychiatric assessment of patient, mental status of person and neuropsychological assessment, laboratory tests to identify the status of the neurochemical, brain imaging that helps to find the area and severity of the disease. It can be done by CT scan, MRI, PET or SPECT. CSF examination can be done. Electroencephalogram and electromyogram can also be done to diagnose the Alzheimer's disease. Now come to the pharmacological interventions for the management of Alzheimer's disease. Acetylcholine esterase inhibitors like donepezil, rivastigmin, galantamine can be prescribed to prevent the breakdown of acetylcholine, which is an important neurotransmitter for learning and memory. Others like NMDA receptor antagonist, example memantine, antidepressant, anxiolytics, antipsychotics, anticonvulsants are prescribed for the symptomatic relief in Alzheimer's disease. There are several psychological interventions for the management of Alzheimer's disease like behavioral approaches, emotion-oriented approaches, cognition-oriented approach, stimulation-oriented approach. The other most important approach is care giving to the patients. Scientists are still continuing research to find out cure of the disease, but still not found. However, they identified potential risk factors as well as medication and modification in lifestyle that helps to manage the behavior of the patient and slow down of the disease progression. Caregiving is an essential treatment and must be carefully managed over the treatment duration of the Alzheimer's disease. I hope I have shared important information about Alzheimer's disease, its etiology, pathophysiology, diagnosis, and treatment approaches. If you like the video, please like and share the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you.